Hey, this is coreWeaver with another episode of Designing Hardware. This video is an intro to what is going to be a long series, I think. I'm going to design and build a universal remote control unit for the most used communication protocols. This project's codename is Juno. I had a little bit of time last weekend and I had this idea to design this product and build it from scratch here till the end, here on YouTube. I just started to work on this and I'm gonna do an episode whenever I make some progress. If you want to get involved in this project, please let me know. Post your comments below. And with that being said, I want to take a moment and say thank you guys for all the positive feedback for the last series, the LC meter. For those who didn't see that yet, there's going to be a link for the playlist of the series. Go and watch that too and tell me what you think. So we're building this remote controller. It's going to have four different communication modules. The first one is a Wi-Fi module, which is great. The second protocol we're going to use is Bluetooth. This is a class 2 Bluetooth module. It works till about 10 meters. I guess we could use a class 1 module and increase the range till about 100 meters, but we're not going to bother with that because the third module we're going to use is a long range radio communication module, and this can send and receive on 868 megahertz till about 2 kilometers, more than 1 mile. This is awesome for controlling something from a long distance. Last but not the least, for short distances and very simple commands, we're going to use an infrared transmitter, still very useful in simple applications. This is roughly what I had in mind, what I'm shooting for in terms of how this product is going to finally look like. This design can change, will probably change. This is going to be the size of a Nintendo Game Boy Advance, a little bit bigger perhaps. I drew inspiration from the PlayStation controller also. As you can see, I'm going to have two digital pads, one left and one right. The difference being that for each D-pad, there's a fifth button in the center. Because I find it very useful, let's say I want to change a value by pressing up and down, and I want to change a submenu by pressing left and right. I can use the center key to set the value or to enter a new section of the menu. I also have two analog sticks, thumbsticks, very smooth. I like this a lot. And I have these configurable keys here. I thought about using this to change between communication protocols, but I guess we'll see. Right in the center, we have a 3.5 inches LCD and it has a touchpad. So I can also implement a graphical user interface, add some graphical buttons or progress bars, stuff like that. I'm going to have two front triggers, one left and one right. This is going to be the antenna for the long range communication module. We're using a rechargeable battery for this, and we're going to recharge it using a micro USB cable. There are multiple LEDs to indicate a lot of stuff here. There's going to be a speaker on this side. I think a piezo speaker will be enough. I'm not planning to play music on this, or at least not yet. Oh, and I almost forgot, I'm going to have a 10 degrees of freedom IMU, which is going to give me the Euler angles, roll, pitch and yaw, so I can control something just by moving this around. Or I could just use the gyroscopes for X, Y, Z, and we'll see. By the way, this is the IMU, which I'm going to use. I believe this is the world's smallest board for a Bosch BNO055 10 degrees of freedom inertial movement unit. This is the sensor here. And the whole board is just under 11 millimeter by 11 millimeter, so it's very small, as you can see. I will make a video very soon about this. Maybe some of you will be interested in it. I didn't have time to sell this until now, but maybe that will change, because this is absolutely awesome. But for now, just let's get back to our current project. I'm going to switch to my computer and I'm going to show you what I did until now. So this is going to be two boards sitting one on top of each other, connected through these headers. This is the top board. It's over 90% finished. There are some small modifications to be made, and I still have to do the silkscreen for the PCB. But other than that, the schematic is finished and the PCB is almost there. I'm using this nice Xmega microcontroller, 128A3U. It's a pretty decent MCU. I used this before in other projects. Here's the IC, which takes care of the touch events on the display, and the display itself, that's going to be the most difficult part to solder on this board. Not the display itself, the connector for the display has 50 pins and it's only 25 millimeter long, and I'm soldering everything on these boards by hand. I don't make stencils for a prototype like this. What else do we have here? These are the thumbsticks, the digital pads, and all the other keys. Oh, and I use a port expander because I ended up with more I/O lines that this microcontroller can handle. This is an I2C I/O expander with interrupt pins. I never used this particular chip before, but it shouldn't be an issue. I do this a lot. Most of the times, so I don't even have a footprint for these parts for a PCB, but it's all there in the data sheets. I guess that's another good reason to make a video in the future, show you guys how to look for parts and then just make a library for them, the schematic symbol, and then link to PCB footprint. So anyway, I'm drifting again. Oh, I forgot this IC here. This is an analog switch because I had to split the UART bus into three separate pairs of RX and TX because I only use one UART. And on the other board, I have three devices which will try to speak and receive at the same time. This is the second board which is going to sit beneath. I'm still working on the schematic here, and the PCB, I've just started to route some things. As soon as I get a little bit of time, I'll finish this too and send the two boards to fabrication. I'm working mostly late evenings on these projects, or at night, or in the weekends. So this board is... there's a little bit more going on this board. Let's start with the charging section. I use this 4056 chip a lot to charge this kind of chemistry, lithium iron or lithium polymer. These are the pin headers which I'm using to connect the boards. The other board that I showed you will sit on top of this board. You can see here the outline of the battery which I'm going to use. This is the power supply. I'm not sure I'm going to stick with this. This is a low dropout voltage regulator here. I think I'm going to need about 400 milliamps. That'll be the total current consumption on these two boards. And the datasheet of this IC says it can provide up to 1 amp. I'm going to need to test some other things before I decide, so this can still change here. These are the LEDs that I'm using. I still have to find the right placement. I do this usually while I'm 3D modeling the case. That helps me a lot to get a definitive pinpoint on things like this. Here's another port expander. There's a second MCU microcontroller on this board, and it has even less I/O pins than the other one on the top board. That's why I'm using another port expander. Here's the speaker, and then here are the four communication modules, the Wi-Fi, the Bluetooth, the long-range radio chip, and the infrared transmitter. There's also the 10 Degrees of Freedom IMU, which I'm going to solder directly on this board. Yeah, so there's still much to be done here. The schematic won't change very much, but the PCB, I just started the routing. So basically, I'll try to solve all the problems on these two boards. Maybe I'm going to start modeling the case too in this time frame, and then I'm going to send the Gerber files to fabrication. And like promised, I'm going to keep updating you guys each time I finish a new step. I'm very excited. This is going to be a nice project, and I can't wait to get the finished PCBs and start soldering. This is what keeps me going, burning the midnight oil, so to speak, whenever I'm in the beginning of a project like this. So I hope I got you guys interested in this, and I'll see you hopefully very soon with a new episode on this. This is coreWeaver with Designing Hardware. It was a pleasure to have you here. Don't forget to subscribe, and see you on the next one.